Pado, regarding po do sa statement niya last hearing. According to her, nag-lunch kayo sometimes in October 2023 sa Linden Suites. Do you confirm that?
Good afternoon again, Mr. Chair. Yes, sir, I confirm that. There was an activity. I think it was a training on procurement. And I'm just not quite sure about the date, but there was such an activity.
October.
October, sir. October, yes.
Apat yata kayo. The two is in DepEd consultant, tama po?
Initially, sir, we were not just four. We were a group, including our staff. And then, but we were in one long table. And yes, with two others, me, Yusek Law, and some other staff, sir.
And during that meeting, according to Yusek Gloria Mercado, nung last hearing po, nilapitan daw siya ni Asik Munsayak. At nagsabing mag-usap-usap na lang kayo tungkol sa bidding para sa DepEd Computerization Program for 2022. According to her, that statement was made to her in your presence. Totoo po ba to?
I recall in that meeting that then ASEC Reynolds Munsayak.
Please answer.
Yes, sorry.
Please be responsive to the question.
Yes, yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, totoo po. Sa pagkakaalala niya po, ano ang sinabi talaga, yung talagang salita ni ASEC Munsayak? Ano po ang naintindihan niyo ron?
We were discussing, I think it was about the utilization of the funds for the procurement, sir. And it was a discussion like there was something like there is a need to be able to utilize the funds immediately. And there was some kind of a remark that, you know, something like maybe pwede naman na lang pag-usapan ng kung paano maayos. Basta importante, ma-utilize yung fund because the fund for the procurement was about to lapse in December of 2023. I understand this fund was 2022, sir. By the way, sir, just for purposes of background, no, I was quite new in the department. I just joined the department sometime in January of this year.
So, bago lang po kayo.
Yes, sir.
At that time, you were already familiar with Mr. Munsayak. Kilala niyo na po siya as assistant secretary?
If I recall it right, I was former HR director, sir. Yeah. So, if I recall it right, ASEC Munsayak was, the appointment of ASEC Munsayak was, I think, October 1st of 2023. So, he was presented as one of the new officers of the DepEd, I think in that flag ceremony of that week. So that was the first time I saw him. And I think the very first interaction with him was on that
so nung
lunch.
Nung marinig niyo po yung statement niya ni ASEC Munsayak, what is your reaction?
I was a bit surprised, but at the same time I was also amused, sir, because as a lawyer, I thought it was just a joke, no? The offhand remark on something like talking about it. I thought it was some kind of a joke. It was just nothing. I didn't really mind it that much.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
So, Mr. Chair, mukhang totoo nga na may naging pahayag si Mr. Munsayak kung saan sinabi niya kay Yusek Gloria na noong panahon na yon, as head of procuring entity, na siyang nagre-review ng dokumento ng mga bidders, pinagsabihan niya nga na ituloy na lang. At kung saan hindi tinanggap ni Yusek Gloria yung mungkahi na yon at dapat masunod yung tamang proseso. Nakakapagtaka lang, Mr. Chair, na si ASEC ay head ng procurement at malapit na kaibigan ni VP Duterte na siya pang nagpahayag o nagpahiwatig sa isang head ng procuring entity at pati na rin sa harap ng isang back chair person. Mr. Osayas, noong huling hearing, sinabi din po ni Yusek Mercado na kayo'y isang director sa DepEd. Totoo po ba ito?
Yes, sir. I was the director of Yusek Law. I was under her strand. as the Director of HR.
Kailan po kayo na-appoint?
I was appointed January 12, I think, and then but I reported January 17 of 2023, Your Honor.
2023?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Ano po yung position niyo talaga?
Director for ho.
Hanggang ilang director po pa daw? Director 6, 7?
Ah, hindi ho. Ang pinakahayas ko na director is Director 4 ho. Sa
Director 4.
Yes, sir.
Ano po yung responsibility ng Director 4?
Depende ho sa assignment, Mr. Chair, Your Honor.
Kayo po, Mr. Osias. Ano po
yes, sir. My responsibility is primarily on HR, Human Resource and Organizational Development. So, kami po yung in charge ng mga programs natin with respect to teachers and then the non-teaching personnel and then yung kami rin po ang in charge doon sa organizational effectiveness and the benefits that we can probably give our teachers so through our offices.
Aside from that position, meron pa ho ba kayong ibang hinawakan sa DepEd?
Well, sometime in November of 2023, sir, I was designated as the chair of the Back 6. No, Back 6 is the early procurement activity designated back.
Back?
Yes, sir. Bids and Awards Committee.
Sige. Na-mention nyo po na back member nung panahon na yon. Sino po ang back chair at that time?
Sir, sa noong November, back chair ho ako. Naging back chair ho ako ng back 6. Ng back 6 ho. Yung back 6. But, yun ho.
Sige po. Hindi ba po pagka ganyang malaking government agency, especially yung DepEd, sometimes maraming mga back assigned for the procurement of particular category. In the back that you specifically belong, ano pong mga bagay yung procurement ang kailangang dumaan sa inyo?
Particular. Yes, sir. As far as I recall, ang dumaan sa akin ho ay laptops.
Laptop?
Yes, sir. Laptops for teaching, non-teaching, and yung DCP project ho.
So, kabilang po dito yung procurement relating to DepEd computerization program.
Yes,
tama
sir.
Po?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. 2024 ang original ko.
Noong back member kayo, naging party po ba kayo ng October and December 2023 bids for the DCP?
Yes, sir. I was also before the 2024 at before the November designation as back chair, I was also part of the DCP 2022 which was bidded in 2023. Yes, sir.
Na-mention nyo rin po na naging back chairperson. Kailan kayo naging chairperson po ng back?
I think if I'm not mistaken, around November na po ng 2023.
November ng 2023.
Or is it December? Something November or December, sir? Kasi my memory is not really at this point.
Na-re-recall nyo pa po yung mga project na dumaan sa inyo as back chair?
Yes, sir. Originally, since I was handling the back 6, it is supposed to be the early procurement activity back, no? The back in charge for early procurement activity. So, kasama ho, yung nare-recall ko ho is the DCP project for 2024 ho sana. For 2024 DCP project and laptop for teachers, laptop for non-teaching personnel. Ganun ho yung aking nare-recall na.
So, up to now po, are you still working with DepEd bilang director at back chair?
Not anymore as back chair, sir, but I am still working with DepEd. Yes, but I am no longer connected with the HR. I have been reassigned under the new administration. I have been reassigned to the office of the Undersecretary for Procurement.
So, pwede kong sabihin, ranking official pa rin kayo ng DepEd?
In terms of the fact that I am an appointed director, sir, yes.
Yeah. And you play an important role kasi kayo parte ng back before, di po ba? That oversees yung DCP, yung computerization. A flagship program of the DepEd. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. As far as I am concerned at that time, yes, sir.
Tanong lang po, would you also receive envelopes from Ms. Shine Paharda? Parang ikinuwento ni Yusek Mercado, envelope containing cash.
Alright, Your Honor, Mr. Chair, no, I must be candid about this. I must say I did, but I didn't know because I was new in the department. I thought it was a practice of the department. I thought, you know, the very first time I encountered that matter, sir, was sometime in April of 2023. I didn't know why I was summoned to the office of ASEC Shine, and then I was given an envelope, and it was later on I found out that there was money in it, but it was not because I was a back member or whatever yet, because I was not at that time.
At that last hearing, sabi ni Yosek Mercado, kung natatandaan ko, 9 envelopes yung natanggap niya, amounting to 50,000 each. Sa inyo pong pagkakaalala, hanggang kailan kayo nakatanggap na envelope? Ilan?
It started April. I think it was until September of that year.
Up to September 2023.
Yes, sir. But if I recall it right, I was only summoned about 4 times to the office.
4 times?
Yes.
Up to September 2023?
Yes, sir.
So yung last quarter po, wala na kayo natanggap?
Wala na po. Wala.
So in other words, wala na kayong envelope na natanggap ng fourth quarter ng 2023. Tama po?
Yes, sir.
Mukhang sumakto ah. Sa panahon na hindi na ginamit ng DepEd yung confidential fund for the last quarter nang pumuputok na issue ng confidential fund. Anyway, Mr. Osias, I think this was also mentioned by the BP na press conference na magkano po pala yung laman? Magkano po laman ng envelope?
I think it was something like between 12 to 15, sir. Hindi ko na ho matandaan yung laman talaga.
12 to 15,000.
Very minimal amount, yes, sir.
Okay. Mr. Osias, last week din po, after nung nandito si Yusek Mercado, meron din pong press conference si Vice President. According to the Vice President, nag-solicit daw po si Yusek Gloria from private companies using the name of the BP, which is supposedly the reason why she was let go. Kaya siya tinanggal. So, based po sa dokumento na inilabas, ito ay patungkol sa programang DepEd Guro. Are you familiar with that project?
Yes, sir. I am familiar with the DepEd Guro project because I am supposed to be the project owner of that program, sir.
Mr. Chai, can you explain to us briefly what this project is about?
Early on, when I joined the department, about maybe a few weeks after I joined the department, and as normally done by former Yusek Glo, no, she would come up with a list of things for us to do. And I recall that there were tasks given to us. I think it was after she went on a birthday trip.
By who?
There were about 40 tasks that has to be accomplished by our strand, the HR and OD strand, including the other components of that strand, sir. So thus the HR strand or the HR OD strand and NAYAP and techs, we had about 40 tasks. Out of the 40, there were about 27 that pertains to my bureau, so for HR and OD. And I recall that one of the priorities of that we were informed, no, by Yusek Law, one of the priorities that we need to deliver as a strand is some kind of a chatbot wherein the secretary can connect directly with our teachers. Meaning that the idea was for her for the teachers to be able to connect with her directly so that she can immediately respond to this.
With the concerns. Secretary.
Yes, yes, sir. And there were 3 assigned to me, and the other 2 were a PDIS, we call it a PDIS, an information system on all the employees of the department. And the other one was a hiring process which will minimize the engagement of the human intervention. So the computations were all done by the system, something like that. So there were three. So DepEd Guru was more on the aspect of that parang immediately makakausap ni VP yung mga teachers so they can immediately raise to her the concern. Kasi the thing there, sir, is if you use the idea there is if you use the current social media processes like Messenger, etc., no? There are about, at that time, there were about 888,000 plus teachers. So just imagine if a teacher comes up with a concern and there were so many of them, matatabunan lang ho yung kanyang concern and there is no possibility for example, the VP to be able to answer the concern. So there has to be some kind of a different approach to it, some kind of technological approach wherein it will ensure that the VP is able to answer all these concerns because there are really many of our teachers.
Thank you.
So the DepEd Guru, sir, is for that purpose.
According to Yusek Mercado din po, at that time, nangailangan din kayo ng external partners para sa project na to. Tama po?
Yes. Actually, as far as I recall, there was an activity wherein our strands were asked, what are your projects? What are your concerns? And we were supposed to, there is an office in DepEd that is supposed to be in charge of coordinating us, the strands or whatever, the concerns of the strands with an external partner. And they're the ones who actually are supposed to help us.
So merong office na in charge para sa pagpili ng external partners? Tama po?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So, sinasabi niyo ba walang direct lang pagpili sa mga external partner? I mean, you and Yusek Mercado, hindi kayo yung namili na external partners. Tama ba?
Yes, sir. I for one, I'm not involved in the process. I just sit there when we make a presentation on what is that guru all about. I'm just part of the people
who sit there. Yeah, so with that, sino ang pumipili o nag-entertain ng mga external partners para sa mga ganyang partners, especially yung DepEd Guru?
There is an office. I think it's the External Partnership Services.
External Partnership
Service or Services. Services. I think that's the office or is it the ICO? It's either of the two.
So, parang isang department sa DepEd yun?
Yes, sir. Yes,
and
sir.
It is not under Yusek Mercado?
No. It's a different office.
So, malayo. Sa pagkakaalam po ninyo, ano yung mga kailangang programang ito mula sa external partners? Why you need that external partners? Ano yung kailangan nyo sa kanila?
Well, from what I understood at that time, the need for the technological thing that the VP wanted to have, we cannot do it on our own because there is no budget for it. So we need external partners to help us make it turn it into fruition or to make it to accomplish that program, sir. So I think that is the answer to that.
When you say external partner, kailangan nyo hindi pera ang sinolicit nyo sa external partner or pera yun?
If I will relate it to the DepEd Guru, it was not money that we wanted to.
Hindi pera.
Yes, sir. It was like because the DepEd Guru has components. No, it's like technology and other matters, no? Hardware, software. So
gamit.
Gamit, sir. I think that is the word. Mga components. So, not really money, sir.
Sir, kung may alam po kayo, anong gamit yun? Kung alam nyo.
Okay, so if I recall this right now, the DepEd Guru will involve for example, sir, some kind of yung ano ho dun sa, for example, sa truck, meron ho sa likod na parang lalagyan ho parang malaking tapos may wheels. Parang ano ba ang tawag dito? Yung parang yung sa likod doon ng truck, 'di ba? For example, mga mga trucks na mga refrigerated trucks, 'di ba? Yung likod do parang may mga closed na portions sa so may gulong.
Yeah.
For example, yan no is one kasi the design is nandun sa loob noon yung mga gadgets na ilalagay. Because the intention was to have three of these kinds of equipment in Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. So, i-deploy ho siya para kung mayroong conflagration, kung mayroong nangyaring masama, hindi ho, una makakausap pa rin ni VP yung mga students or concerns or whatever. And then, independently powered ho siya, component ho siya talaga ng buo. So, meron siyang laptops, meron siyang solar panel. Marami siyang components, sir, para ma-ensure lang na kahit walang kuryente dun sa lugar, tuloy-tuloy pa rin ang magiging communication ng VP. Ganun ang pagkaintindi ko doon sa...
So, Mr. Chair, with that yung equipment na yun, kanino po mapupunta yun or saan napunta yun?
Hindi ho natuloy yung project.
Sir. So, hindi natuloy?
Hindi natuloy.
So, walang nakuha na personal na pera o gamit, equipment, si Yusek Mercado sa paghanap niya ng external partner para sa DepEd Guru program? Negative?
I can only speak up to the extent that I interact with USEC Law, like for example in the office. If that is the basis of that, the premise, I don't think there was any. Kasi wala naman, hindi naman ho natuloy yung project.
Sige. Sa pagkakaalam niyo po, Mr. Chair, palagay niyo ba importante itong project na to na magkaroon ng direktang komunikasyon yung halos 900,000, almost 1 million na teacher at si BP sa ilalim ng Guru program?
I can only speak, sir, from experience, no? I am a survivor of the Yolanda tragedy. It almost killed me and my family. As far as I'm concerned, there is really a need to have things like this during a conflagration, especially for purposes of our kids, no, continuing with their education despite everything that happens, no. So, to my mind, it is something that we really need to have. But of course, the program did not push through, so it's not something.
So, in short, ito yung naging priority project ni BP Duterte sana.
Sir, that was the information I got or we got from the USEC. Kasi siya naman ho ang nakakausap sa EXICOM. Hindi naman ho ako involved. Kung ano lang ho yung binababa sa amin, yun lang ho yung aming extent ng knowledge kung ano ang mga kailangan ho talaga.
Ano bang difference ng priority project kumpara do sa regular project nyo sa DepEd?
The way I understood it, sir, is that ang priority projects, these are immediate ang need. No? While the other projects, these are projects, many of the other projects have been there for the longest time pero hindi ho gumagalaw. That's why, as I was saying earlier, there were about 40 that the Strand, HROD and NAYAP and TEX had to do, no? These were the 40 identified projects that we need to do. But out of the 40, 27 are for the BHROD. And out of the 27, there were about 3 that were priority projects of the VP, including yung chatbot nga ho, or itong naging guro ang aming pinag-usapan.
Thank you po. So in short, talagang alam niya to at priority project to ni Vice President Sara Duterte. Tama po ba?
Well, I am not quite sure if the VP directly know about the project, but we present this project every time there is a Strand or EXICOM or EXICOM meetings, or I think that is when it is presented. But EXICOM hindi na ho kasi ako kasali doon.
So, she is aware. So in short, Mr. Chairman, ang DepEd Guru Program sa katotohanan ay isang legitimate project ng DepEd na isang priority project rin ni BP Duterte, kung saan ang mga external partners sa hindi pinili ni Yusek Mercado kundi ng ibang opisina sa ilalim ng DepEd. Dagdag pa rito, walang pondo o kagamitan na personal na makukuha si Yusek Mercado sa programang ito. Nakakabahala lang, Mr. Chair, na isang directive ng pinuno ay siya rin gagawing rason na paikot-ikutin upang sapilitang magtanggal ng isang career government official tulad ni Yusek Gloria Mercado. And that's all, Mr. Chair. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, Chairman.
Yes, Congressman Abante, you are recognized.
Attorney Ocias admitted that he has received envelopes. I'm not saying it's wrong, no? It can be an appreciation thing or a love gift, whatever it might be. I don't think it's wrong. Pero if that is actually the habit of the secretary to give envelopes to his to her people, I wonder if only Yusek Mercado or you receive envelope. Perhaps Yusek Mempin should also say something about that, or anybody here among the DepEd family. Because as I've said, no, when you receive an envelope, there was no thinking that there's anything wrong with that. Wala kaming inaisip na masama yan. No, just, you know, you're under oath and just tell us about it. And thank you for telling us that. Yes.
Sir, again, I must say that when I was called and, you know, received an envelope, I initially thought that it is how it is in DepEd, because I did not come from DepEd. So, to be honest, I was grateful, because it helps a lot. No, we are from the I am from the province, so parang nakakatulog.
Where were you before, Attorney Ariel Ocia? Before you went to DepEd, where were you before?
I spent more or less 25 years in another agency, sir.
In the private?
No, government also.
Government,
sir.
Then?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay.
I just came across the DepEd, ano yun, yung posting.
So you were thinking that, you know, receiving an envelope is just something that that happens in DepEd once in a while, or and you're grateful. I really appreciate that. No, as I've said, we're not thinking of